channel. This is Ipek. Today we are going to see how to make our own homemade blackened seasoning. I prefer to make my own seasonings like blackened or taco because that way it is more healthier and it is more cheaper. When you buy seasoning from store, you can check the ingredients in it. It has a lot of things that I don't want to put in my body and I'm sure you don't want to put in either. That's why I'm buying my own spices separately and I can use them in the different dishes or I can make my own mixed seasonings. Another good thing to make your own homemade seasoning is you can make big amount and storage in a proper way so you can use it whenever you need. For your seasonings and also for your spices, it's important where you're storing them. It should be in a dry area that is not taking any light in it. And also before you store it, you need to put inside the Ziploc bag or some type of container that is not taking any air. That way your seasonings and your spices are going to be good up to a year. One thing about making your own seasoning at home is you can make big amount to use it later whenever you want. Blackened seasoning, as most of you know probably, can be used with chicken or seafood and it is really delicious because it has all delicious spices in it like paprika, cayenne, oregano, basil. I was going to use dry thyme too, but then I realized I don't have it. So if you have dry thyme, make sure to add because it will make it way more tasty. I hope this short video will help you to make your own blackened seasoning at home. Don't forget to subscribe and like. See you guys in the next videos.